So the first thing you want to do is go to your control panel. Go to hardware and sound, sound. Then this window should open. Go to recording and scroll down to your microphone. In my case, I'm using the Yeti Classic. You want to click on this and go to properties. And then you want to go to advanced. There should be a section called exclusive mode, and there's a checkbox right next to a phrase saying allow applications to take exclusive control of this device. You want to uncheck this box. This may solve some of your problems, but it may not solve all of them, because this does not necessarily mean applications do not lose full control of your device. I don't know why, but that's really how it's set up. So once you have done that, you want to go to levels and choose your microphone level that is suitable for you. I use 90, it seems to work out for me. So the next thing you want to do is go to your system settings. Under your system settings, there should be a systems tab. You want to click that, go to sound, and then go to microphone privacy settings. Now this is going to show applications that have access to your microphone. You want to leave allow apps to access your microphone, because this means every application will have capability of accessing your microphone, which is important for applications that you do use that do need your microphone. So that's kind of obvious. However, you could turn off all these Microsoft Store apps, or at least applications that you don't use. I don't use any of these, so I turned them all off. Do keep this on, because these are applications that you have installed personally that have access to your microphone. So since you have installed them, I'm assuming you use these applications to your capability on a daily basis or somewhat frequent time. So for example, I have Adobe Audition, Discord, Forza, and so on. It's good to know what applications do have access to your microphone so you can start troubleshooting and go through each application that is shown here to see if a setting has been turned on with each respective application that has access to your microphone. And more than likely you would be able to turn off that setting just like how we did into the control panel. I am not going to be able to go through all the applications and show you how to turn off that feature because I do not know what applications you have installed into your computer. I will use one application as an example, and that will be Steam. So if you open up Steam and go to your friends and then go to your settings, which is the cogwheel, go to voice, scroll all the way down to show advanced settings, and there should be a section or a feature that is named automatic volume slash gain control. You want to turn that off. So you want to go through your applications that are shown in that systems window to turn off a feature like this. Now, if you're unfortunate like I am, and you have a Logitech G Hub installed, there's no way to turn off that setting. As you can see, my Yeti is connected to this application, and there's no way you could disable the microphone or disconnect your microphone from this application as far as I can tell. Logitech automatically puts it into its software once it's connected. So an application like this, what I would do is set your input gain to your desired level, as I said was 90, and just set that as default for those applications so that every time when you boot up your PC, you go to 90 or whatever setting that you have default. So that's pretty much it. Hopefully this helped you guys. If you have any questions, please let me know. I'll see you next time.